So, predictions before we enter this matchup. Now, we've obviously discussed a little bit about the mental state and how they could progress and how they've been performing leading up to this Grand Finals. How do you think it's going to go? Is this going to be a bracket reset, or do you feel like Chicago Dogos are going to do it just by one set?
I can go map by map. I think in Vail, I need to look at the...
Chicago Dogos, surely.
Yeah, but I'm going even, like, thinking of the champions first, because, like, at Chicago Dogos, they're likely going to play Keel and the Ranger or something like that.
We've
and
seen
then,
that a couple times,
and then Cheaters probably go Ranger and Sorlak. And I think... it's going to be like Keel versus Sorlak. Like, I kind of favor the Sorlak, but it's a map that really favors Chicago Dogos.
You're so slow at your predictions, you guys.
It's fine. I'm just doing
now.
Map per map. It's fine. I think Chicago Dogos is the first map.
So I'm lethal. You lethal.
Pardon?
Take us away, lethal.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, because I was a little bit worried about what was going on. But we're going to go into the Grand Finals here in this first map on Vail between Chicago Dogos and Cheaters to see who's going to be the winners here at Barcelona KeenCon 2024. As we can start off from Max's perspective.
Yeah, you heard for the Grand Finals.
And we
very
do.
Nice.
Nice and golden. See it? And already Kelt's whipping up that rail to actually both of them take them out. And now it's 3-1 in favor of Cheaters.
So Kelt's taking a page out of Chenzo's book. I'm going with Athena. And Siri is going with the heal? What? I've never seen either of them use these champion picks on this map before. So this is new territory for me.
They're very interesting picks and still using that Athena for rail, which is not something you've seen too often. Don't get me wrong, we saw it once before and it worked.
But not my Kelt. Really good Athena, but with Sirius, it doesn't really matter what champion he has, because his playstyle doesn't depend on the champion. But still, it's a new combo for them. With synergies that they probably haven't really explored before.
Yeah.
So there's telepathy, he's got to be stronger than Hammer.
Pretty good so far, as Sirius
like
and Kelt have actually slowed things down a little bit, but now Sirius needs to move out of position because Kelt was actually taking quite a bit of damage. But even if he drops down, he might get caught off guard here. Kelt's trying to get in there as soon as physically possible. Quartz coming up in 5. Are going to be in position. Rapper is matched to below and literally managed to take it down. Will he still be able to grab it? Yes, he does. With the orb, which means it's going to be the Quartz in favor of Chicago Dogos.
There's the heavy too. So Rapper has everything to play with, a lot of stack. There's the rocket, there's the rail. Now he's going to be hunting for frags. Can he find someone? Quartz actually got the kill. Great. He picks a rail by Rafa. Mega was already taken, so he's going to be try and keep hunting. He's still his team behind by one frag, and hopefully he can close up the gap just then, find Sirius. But Kelt brings back one frag ahead on their favor.
Almost a good predictive rocket, but he was definitely right in terms of the area of which Cheaters were located, and you've got to remember as well, they had that quad.
Not the
and
really
Cheaters
successful.
Still in the lead, exactly. Yeah. Didn't really get the maximum.
At the end of it, it's kind of the same as it was, because Rafa got 3 frags, but Maxer died 3 times. So they were behind by 1, they're still down by 1. Nothing really changed.
Managed to get a little bit of damage there, but Sirius's LG was just unreal, pushing him into the LG stairs, and Sirius coming up to 22 HP, make that 4. Finally gets taken down by Kelt. A little bit too late, but Rafa then finishes him up straight away with that orb. Really making good use of the orb here. And Sirius just trying to stay alive at the moment as we've got Heavy coming up in 20. Mega's already just been picked up and protection in 40. So these next items are going to be crucial for contesting the item.
Double
and a nice
Maxter.
Rocket by Maxter.
Double my Maxter helps him get back some of the frags. And now they're actually in the lead. Sirius not a lot to play with. And with Keel, it's kind of uncomfortable to play until you get at least the rocket launcher. The heavy machine gun for him is just enough damage, honestly.
Maxter trying to gain once again.
Power up coming up soon. You can see Chicago Dogos already trying to get the well position for it. Great kill by Max, by Rafa. They're already set up. And both Kelt and Sirius are below. I guess Kelt is going to try to do another hook up, but if you see Rafa, he has the orb in the open. It's Kelt's steals, can he get away? He can't. No, he can't, because they drop down on him, and Sirius was not there to help him right in time. So another power run by Chicago Dogos. Can they get a few more frags this time around?
Again, Rafa and Max just... wouldn't say pure domination for these power-ups, but at least making sure they're secured. Yeah, exactly.
I think we're doing power-ups for them,
But yeah. They don't really get frags with it. No. They were up by 2 frags before the power up. They're still up by 2.
It's been more for denial purposes more than anything. And as you can see, Sirius taking down Maxwell and that pineapple in air as well. And actually managed to get top of the goal as well. Sirius still doing a fair amount of damage. And Kels is there, but let's say wasn't able to take out the heavy. I think he just realized. I thought, oh, okay, maybe I could have gone for
and
that.
It didn't work at all. Actually getting the kill. They do miss out on both major items. Not that bad. Maxwell trying to come in, but Kels there to help Sirius. He just threw the machine gun. He drops down onto 2 players. Kels doesn't quite have the stack to help. And I'm still kind of confused about the team dynamics of these two champion picks on this map.
And he's only done 3 for 3 rails. Yeah. Finally, Max detects it down, but he got a lot of value for his life next to him, the stack he was on. And Sirius managed to stay alive, but at least he burned the heavy. That was huge.
Exactly. And now, after spawn, he's going to have much more stack than both of the Chicago Dogs player. So he's surely going to use that to his advantage. There's Athena using the verticality. Kels does not seem completely comfortable with the movement yet. Oh, getting pummeled there. Is he going to come to the teleporter and help? No, he's on the other side of the map waiting for the heavy that spawns in 15 seconds.
I was waiting for the thing there. Sirius to take down Rafa. Max to get the trade on the Sirius. And Kels with the high ground onto the Mega. But the problem is Quad is coming up in 10. And looking at the stack, Chicago Dogos aren't looking too good for contesting this Quad. It's maybe potentially be a guarantee, but Max is looking to maybe sneak. We have to grab that quad, but it's going to put a halt to that, and that's going to be Sirius at the final, but might just get Rafa as well. So the quad is in the go in favor of Cheetahs, and this is now going to be their time to shine and try and extend their lead from 3 to God knows what, considering their circumstances.
I'm gonna get that off Kevin.
I'm dead. No, I'm fine. I'm coming to you. I need
Kevin. I'll give it all.
There you go.
Thank you. Getting? He got it, 23. Can I do my game?
I'm going real.
That was good from Chicago Dogos, in my opinion. Considering they could get this, they have that crossfire giant if the quad came after them and the pummel comes out.
Although, they got more frags in that one power-up run than Chicago Dogos got in their 2 power-up runs.
Pretty much.
So a little bit more effective power-up runs by Cheetahs. And they're still on Chicago Dogos' map. They are very, very, very close. Even though they have really good champion picks. I dig it. I don't think Chicago Dogos would have expected these picks, so they don't really have a plan for it.
Do you reckon Cheetahs expected it?
No, that's why nobody has a plan for it.
Deary me. Cheetahs up by 3, even though they haven't had as many power-ups aside for the Chicago Dogos, but they're looking very good here. But Maxa is one big stack here, waiting for that. Heavy and Kelsmar pushes a little bit too far, but did quite a fair amount of damage onto Maxter before it was taken down. But Kels does take them right in the meantime, and trying to find another onto Maxter.
I don't think I've seen Chicago Dogos take a 3 item yet. Every time they try to take an item, they get railed or rocketed or they get killed right after. Really good effectiveness on the items by Cheetahs. Even if they're not getting it, they're at least making them pay with their lives or a lot of damage.
It's good though, they're performing pretty much the same as how they did in that lower bracket final. We haven't seen any sort of minor changes which is going to affect their gameplay from a dramatic standpoint.
Now the power is coming. Maxis just goes down. Where is Rafa still fighting there? Can Rafa take it? No, it's a power up for Sirius. And they get 2 kills immediately. They now have a frag lead of 6. This is the territory for me, both in champion picks and how this map is going.
Looks like they're both hanging around that rail room, but one of them's trying to split open and get apart and actually get away from TP. Rafa does manage to get killed in the meantime, but Sirius is on a field day in the moment. Pretty much his playground here with his protection. Only about 5 seconds left until that protection is over, but Sirius is definitely getting a lot more out of his power compared to the previous one.
They've gotten so many power. They've gotten the last 2 power-ups. Usually people don't really get 2 power-ups in a row versus Chicago Dogos, but Cheetahs kind of defying all expectations so far. They are leading by 8. Can they keep it going until the end of the map? Honestly, getting the first map win is going to be paramount for their confidence going into the rest of the game, especially taking down Chicago Dogos map.
So that by 9 at the 8.5 minute mark, Sirius is making sure to try and stay alive. It gives off life long enough to get that heavy.
Kels slowly.
And Kels managed to grab it, and Kels is still on standby here with a huge stack. I just added more damage here onto Chicago Dogos. Just trying to get away, but Kels is just barely missing here. Just back-to-back round, 3 out of 4 there. And trying to finish up with a nail, but Maxter finally cleans him up with the pineapple. But Sirius just chased him with 3 HP. They just don't care.
I love Kels weapon selection. Right now he's starting with steel nailgun as starting weapon, and he's had it for, you know, quite a few hours now. It's kind of working out because nailgun, the starting nailgun was buffed in the last patch, so he's doing 15 damage now. So he's being very, very effective. 8 frag lead, power up coming soon. Rafa not really stacked for this. Thankfully, he will have the orb and a few health levels to help him. But oh, that if he rails him once more, I'm not sure if Rafa's gonna be able to get there on time. Let's go listen in to the team comps as we prepare for possibly the last power up. He gets it, but he goes down. Serious, they can win the game.
They certainly could, yeah. Only 3 frags left as we're pushing 10 minutes and Sirius is continuing to absolutely pop movement here. 3 power-ups in a row. Sirius now, the targets to literally track on, and already now 1 more left for Cheetah to try and get this first map victory. Wow. And a lovely way to finish things off. Cheetahs up 1-0 in this grand final.
I gotta say, that was the most impressive and dominating performance I've seen from this team. It's like they are a completely different team to what they were 4 hours ago.
Literally every milestone now, bar one, which is really impressive, and the community have been fantastic just making those contributions. But now going to head into the second map, as you rightly said, their map pick. They've been extremely good on Exile, pretty much against everyone, and let's see if they can continue with that track record, or if Maxter and Rafa have something else to say about it, as we're now going to kick things off from Sirius' perspective already with the heavy. And now he's going to rotate back around, and Kelt's already being cleaned up by Max's heavy machine gun.
They did lose this map earlier versus Cheaters, but they still decided to go in and choose it again. They have not lost confidence. And how could they? After losing after winning eight maps in a row, their confidence must be at an all-time high. Maybe coming soon. Sirius already in position, not quite landing the shots, which has been uncommon.
Yeah, a bit weird from their perspective, as Chicago Dogos have had that early lead, as Kelt had to take on a couple of 1v2s while Sirius was on the back line.
Kelt started on the Athena. It's been 40 seconds. He's already swapped to BJ. So the Athena not quite working out. I respect it. They want to try something that didn't work. Instant switch, so the adaptation is there. Sorlai does well on this map. We don't often see it either.
No, we don't. No, I want to say this for the first time because normally we've been seeing it on Veil. But the reason why I also respect that change this early on, because we've seen it a couple of times where Cheetahs have made the change when it's way too late into the game and it's not going to be any more beneficial just due to the circumstances that they place themselves in. So a minute in, already Chicago Dogos are now up 6-3. Quad's coming up, and this is going to be the game changer here in the next 12 seconds. Sirius is going to get in position. One of the players with an actually cool Rafa there off guard. He was actually looking to try and feed info, but Sirius is only on 11 HP with 3 seconds left remaining to try and get this.
He's going to go for another angle.
But it looks like he's going to turn the back away. And Max is now great orb as well. Now we can see what he can do with his quad to extend their lead.
And he has the timing of all the items, just needs to find the kills now. They're leading by 3. Meg is up, Rafa is going to be able to take it, and Maxer is the kill onto Sirius. How many more can he get with this? I think he knows where the other player is. Oh, apparently not. He's gotten a call from Rafa. One player is at the rail. He's just behind you. Just missed out the timing there a little bit to get the kill. And again, they got a couple of kills, but it was brought back to the same score difference almost immediately. And they actually missed out on the heavy as well, so Kelt, I think, collecting that heavy.
Trying to value his life as much as possible, but Kelt managed to pretty much run and gun in that situation and wasn't really too bothered. Rafa does take down Sirius, and Kelt just needs to stay alive here. But you've got to remember, the item's a bit of time until they appear, as he's trying to get him to position early, but there wasn't really too much he could have done anyway with the stun. And now he's getting into an engagement with Rafa. He's going to win that outright with the LG. Great stuff there to try and get some back in the matchup. And it's quite interesting, but still Cheetahs only down by 2. Now by 1, but Sirius still put on the huge amount of damage, continuing to fall through down below from Rockets. And Rafa gets a very important double picked up in this. In order to try and get heavy, Mega's been picked up as well, and the protection will be up shortly after. So these two items are going to be crucial to the stacks to contest the protection.
Yeah, indeed, and right now we don't really see the game going either way yet. Let's not forget though that Veil kind of also started like this until he reached the 30 frag mark. That's when, after a few power-ups, when control starts getting a little bit more set in. And for right now, Maxer has been getting all of the items. Okay, that's coming, the second power-up. Kelt dies immediately before it. Sirius? I think they know where Sirius is, and Kelt Sirius just changed his position, so they might not exactly know where he is, but they see Kels coming in, Sirius jumping in as well. They don't get, they get kill on Max there, but Rafa gets the kill, gets the power up. No real item spawning just yet. Right, Chase for a couple of kills, gets Kels, gets the heavy, he knows the mega timing as well, I'm sure.
Rafa's just calling out one of the items as well. Mega has been collected and almost managed to.
See, Gary was almost smiling there.
He was with that huge stack of protection. Yeah, he'll definitely be slamming the desk off of that one, but managed to stay on board. And Heavy's going up in 10, but Rafa's still got time to kind of linger around the map and just ring around the rotate to see what he can find. Hasn't found anything, but Kelt does take down Maxter in the meantime with the support from Sirius. Oh, does pick up the heavy. Great rail coming up from Rafa and just trying to recuperate and try and recover. But again, takes down Sirius. Great play from Rafa, just staying alive and, well, just in a value in his life and getting additional frags out of the tally. 22 to 13 now.
Yeah, they've been putting a lot of resources trying to get the kill on Rafa, but they even if they hit him every time he goes for an item, they are still not getting the kills. And worse than that, they are getting killed at every item they try and shoot. Finally, getting rid of Rafa, and they get the kill on Max here as well. They should be able to collect the heavy. So maybe a little bit of momentum can stem from this. Let's find out. You know where Mega is? I don't really do the damage there. They tried their best.
Well there, but still trying to give him out of position. Wow. Max was actually directly on the Rafa was actually directly underneath, making a rotation behind him, but Max couldn't stay alive long enough. As Heavy will be up in the Sirius is now trying to use the LG to try and press the rest, but Max had other ideas with the Heavy Machine Gun. And that was a huge play coming up from Kelts. We're now going to go for a listening with the teams on the stage to see how we're going to try and pick up this next quad.
We're both here.
Yes. Okay. Copy for Kevin. Yes. 44. I'm with you.
He's coming.
Perfect. You should just die, actually. Give. Okay. Give. Now. Got it. Okay. 60. Cuts. Got it.
Oh,
not dead.
No.
Okay. It's at cuts. It's going to take him a bit to get there.
It's fine. I'm not too busy.
No, it's still there. Okay, he's healthy and Mega's up.
He can't get it.
I got Mega. One here.
That was crazy how not only did they take out the quad player with the stack that Rafa had, but also stopping him from going cuts and actually doing all that damage just because they couldn't get into the room in the first place. Unreal. And now it's going to help the lads on the side of Cheetahs to make some form of comeback here. They were down by 10 to 12, and now they're only down by 8.
I gotta say, I think the power-ups, not like the control-wise or like the who's gotten hurt, but before and after each power-up, the Cheetahs seem to be getting more frags, even if they're not getting the power-ups itself. It's outside of power-ups that they're really missing out on control a lot of the times.
Yeah.
There goes another, again, there goes another clean heavy this time around for Maxer and Rafa. And Cheetahs just missing out on these items every single time.
Operations running smooth.
Down by 7 minutes in. Sirius literally just trying to stay alive, but trying to at least go from shoddy to cuts, but that's not going to happen at all. Good rail coming out from Rafa there to try and extend their lead back to what it was before. Only up by 9. Great orb coming out from Maxter, and now looking to do further damage onto Kels, who's managed to get away. Leaving the heavy up at the moment to pick up for Rafa, and now he's going to rotate back around and use that mobility to try and make a crucial route to get behind this. Danger's going to be up any second now. Rafa does manage to take down one, and that is going to be Kelts laying down after that rail coming out from Rafa. But good play from Maxter, distracting both players at the time to give Rafa a little bit of room in order to manage to pick up those slays.
Yeah, they kind of messed up there a little bit on the mega timing, but no harm done. Rafa is still has the protection, and yes, he's quite a few fights. Now they're extending the frag lead. It's now a 13 frags in the lead, and it seems that they're kind of dominating Cheetahs like they were dominating their map. It's kind of surprising, to say the least.
It's quite incredible how they're actually dominating on each other's map pick as well. It's we've seen that a few times today, which has been pretty interesting. Now Heavy will up next 5 seconds. They've been having a pretty good time in terms of item control and the preparations for it and the position, of course, to go along with it too. 14-27. Oh my goodness. Maxa just continuing to lay down the law there from above. 43-27. Pretty much all but over now. I kind of feel like the only way cheaters can come back in this is if they get the next two, maybe three power-ups, but even lucky to even get to the next power-up.
50 seconds away, they may basically have to play for all the single then. But then they need to get this next heavy, and they don't. They give out the clean frag, the clean heavy pickup. Kel's now getting a lot of damage on Rafa. Rafa is just going to be waiting for this light timer to be up, which is up to the timing as well. Mega up soon, and Rafa just going to collect five frags until cheaters, until the Chicago Dogos take this to a third map. Incoming quad. Power up coming in 10 seconds. I'm not sure there's a lot that cheaters can do now to prevent us from going to an early third map. They really need a good power up in front this time around. Kelts gets it. Can he do anything with it though? Oh, he's just going to go down. Maxer raining down rockets. Seals gets it. Gets the kill. Mega is up, but he's so low that he can't even peek. Can he find anything? Okay, that's why he gets the Mega. Okay. He's gonna need a lot more than that, but that's the good start, I suppose.
Yeah, he certainly will, but at least he's got a huge stack, but it's gonna be a tall order. We'll see if this comeback even happens. We see some crazy comebacks. Especially early on yesterday, but it's gonna be a little bit too much in my opinion. This series is trying to stay alive and hope that someone Kels actually comes from behind and takes down Rafa, and it looks like he was able to. So yeah, good coordination
maybe
there.
Soon. We need to push for that title. Chicago Dogos both already there. They will get a clean heavy. This series and Kels are playing super defensive with the position now. But if they're getting the kills, it works. Because with their with the aim difference that they have, they can kind of go for this style. Max, however, uses the ability to get one more kill. It's now 48-37.
Max to get three rails in a row. Could be on par with series at the time.
It still doesn't feel possible. Jump pad.
No, I don't think so. The way they're playing now, and all Sears stays alive here, but he's going to drop down a four for Heavy. Great rail coming up from Sears. There's good support coming up from Kels there, as they're still pushing on forward, but Kels, only on 70 HP, needs to stay alive, manages to, but Sears is also so, so weak, and the protections come up in 25 seconds. This is going to be crucial. There's no way he's going to be able to, and oh, they actually both technically got affected by the spin and taken down, and it's going to be all tied up here in this gap. We know that they like to be at the power-up early on Blood Covenant, and we need to see some tremendous plays to break their setup if they do get it early or prepare for the stack. So, Insul's catching a little bit, mate. You'll probably take over me if it gets to map number five, and Zoot, you're back on board. As we're going to start things off with Maxter here on Blood Covenant, and we're going to see what we're going to be able to do to potentially win the second map. Or they're going to take it, but Maxter's already taken down with the Trail Bear from Slash. And now on the hunt for Sirius, but that, Sirius be able to get away.
That Sirius did get a chance to get himself a railgun just there, so he has got something to work with. Oh Kelts gets himself a quick double kill, so Cheetah's right back in there. Rafa also with a rail.
Yeah, so Max literally straight line, didn't he, when Kelts had the LG, so that was quite clean from him.
Got a weak Athena on the side of Cheetah. Rafa taking a bunch of LG damage. We got another rotation at least until we get over to the power-ups. Where are those players? By the teleporter, not going to go through. Not going to make themselves vulnerable to Rafa on that top part of the map. Just seeing Sirius LG'ing out maxed up at the rail again. As we said, that important part of the map that we need to see controlled.
Waiting for this next Mega. Is he going to be contested for it? Rightly so. Max has actually taken down Kelts. But Sirius is only on 10 HP. Gets cleaned up by Max there as he went on the flank. Great play from Max there for the double and good support coming up from Rafa. Now at 4 apiece. What is going to be up in the next 12 seconds? How are Sirius and Kelts going to prepare for this? As you can see, Kelts is still dancing around the pillars. Actually, when he tries to chop someone down, he's taken quite a lot of damage, but Sirius is going to try and get on in here. 3 seconds there, Rafa takes him down. Kelts is the only one that's standing here. So weak, and Rafa does finish him with the heavy machine gun, and he's got the Mega to boot. Now he can just take full advantage of this quad.
That was almost a really good distraction there by Kelts as Sirius coming through the top, but Rafa managed to pivot his focus at just the right time to deal with pressures from both sides. So it's an excellent start to map three for the Dogos. But can they be stopped? Just a quick double there. Both the players on the Chicago Dogos. Out here following up on the rail. Sirius trying to get a little bit of control, but he is going to drop right back down.
Certainly were a little LG engagements between Rafa and Kelts, and Kelts actually comes out on top of that one, switching to the shoddy and cleaning up. Maxit gets a very crucial first rail, looking for the second, but you can see just barely manages to get away, and he just realizes that he's actually completely gone. You're right, as Sirius does take down Rafa there. So at least down by four so far, considering the quad was in favor of Rafa and Maxa to begin with. Protection up in a minute, but more importantly, both Mega and Heavy, almost in sync, going to be coming up shortly. But Maxa, will he be able to get it? Just had to take that last rail, and again, trying to stop him.
Oh, no more pressure on him, so he's going to get away with a lot of health and armor just there. Onto the next rotation across the other side. Oh, the Mega's been taken, never mind. Brilliant shots, Maxa. Can you find another vertical rail?
Oh, we actually go after with the LG, and I think Maxter wasn't really too sure. I think he was more expecting them to go through the LG tunnel and then go back around, but instead just go straight forward with the LG, guns blazing, and almost got away with it.
I'm not sure what Kelts' plan was going off the bounce pad. He's just trying to keep pressure, keep them low, make control difficult. Kelts and Sirius have just got themselves away with a couple of kills, and I think that Heavy went over to... I think both major items went over to Cheetahs. That's essential now moving into the next power-up. It is going to be protection. They are keeping the game pretty close. Can they bring themselves into the power-up room now?
Oh, they're both going to go for it. They're going for it, but it looks like they managed to grab it before he's entered even the room, and Rafa's able to take down Sirius.
There was just a little bit late on the timings just there. Sirius needed to swing in just a fraction before. It was just too simple for Rafa to just step onto the protection, essentially, as simple as that. Rafa still with some overstacked health.
560 HP, roughly, you'll be all right.
Right, there we go. 16 to 12, considering the power-up control has seen so far, it's really not too bad of a scoreline for Cheetahs. But they need to bring this back. Otherwise, this is going to end up being that one map loss and then sweep of the rest of the best of five.
The fact that they're keeping this competitive after two power-ups is a strong showing from Cheetahs, and it feels like for them there's definitely a way back in. But not only that, think of all the weapon denial they've had to deal with, as well as the item control, and still only down by four frags. Let's see how this is going to go, as the Mega and Heavy will be coming up quite soon.
Kelts and Sirius moving around the map quite a bit together. A little 1v1 there. Kelts taking down Rafa. Maxter not got a ton to work with, but he is getting the damage output. There goes Kelts with Heavy up. Maxter the control all on his own, completely unchallenged over there. So we're going to have to do a bit of a guess timing on the side of Cheetahs. Can't find the damage quite, but the rocket's going to find him behind the pillars. 11 HP, where do you go?
Max to the last 30 seconds, it's basically just been unstoppable. The damage output he's displayed so far has been crucial to keeping this scoreline from getting any more competitive.
Well, we've got the Heavy about to spawn. Cheetahs are going to be looking to pick that pretty cleanly. It is going to go over to the Slash, who is healing up a little bit from that. Mega health has been taken. We need Cheetahs to get a good setup on this power-up. Sirius takes down Rafa. Maxter is somewhat fighting on his own over here, but where is Kelts to help out with this? He's trying to get some damage done, but they're not able to take them out. There's a stray rocket, but Maxter, he deals with the pressure. Three power-ups in a row now. Maxter with limited stack will probably wait for this mega health and then try to go on a bit of a frag run.
Yeah, it just seems to be getting a little bit too late to the party each and every time, which has been a little bit unfortunate here, but again, another quad, and I kind of feel like every time they get a power-up, they extend their lead by two. It seems to be a running track record, now up by seven. Not getting the most out of it, but the main prerogative there is just to deny your opponents from the power-up
And he's retained stack. You can see the Rafa's healthy with the armor. They're meeting at the same time over the rail. A quick takedown on Sirius and punishing the mega health immediately. Reaping the benefits for minimal amounts of time, and a phenomenal rails there from Maxter. Rafa picking things up, but very much a team effort.
Oh my god, that LG just pinning him into the corner. Maxter has literally switched it from 10 to 12 at this stage. But in all fairness, the last few minutes he's just been extremely impressive and very difficult for both Sirius and Kelts to kind of tackle and finally taking him down.
Maxter, though, he's just the anchor here on the Mega Health, making sure those items are getting taken, making sure that the team is holding on to a semblance of the control. It's putting a lot of stress here. Oh my god, Maxter with a crucial shot. And again, he's just going around, swiping up all the items. What an enormous stack to be having as a light champion. And look, they can pretty much set up for the power-up now. It's going to be Mega Health. They won't worry about the heavy armor as the protection spawns. And if Maxter doesn't take any damage, I don't really know how the cheaters break in to get the power-up. That's going to be four power-ups in a row at this point.
There's nothing they can do. Rafa needs to try and defend the power-up area as much as possible so Maxter can grab his protection. Obviously, Maxter's staying up, but to try to fly on in, having to back away. He's been derailed. He's going villain outside the TP to try and cause distraction. Managed to find this still the protection, but is it going to be enough? Oh. Yes, it will. It's serious to that close range rail. And now this is their time to try and close this gap. Now down by 10, and still got a lot of protection left, and Sirius is getting a lot of rails out of it during this course.
Sirius, now you have to show us why you are known as the aim god. You've got to be hitting everything. He's already been hitting every single rail as we've gone to him. I'm cursing him a little bit, but he is under a lot of pressure at the moment. They have 9 frags to make up just to tie things up, and protection is about to run out, and they have to start thinking about the items. Both players here around the heavy armor, and it is a rapper fearing for his life. There's a close range rail, and Kelt's following up. This is perfect for them. Make sure that they secure that heavy armor. It looks like Sirius really wants to stress onto the Mega Health and make sure that they're not getting too many benefits from that as well.
Goodness.
Beautiful damage we're getting from Sirius.
Aim skill coming up from Sirius here. It was exactly what was required. Rafa has taken down Kelts, mind you, but they have closed the gap. It was by 12 or 13 now, down to 8. Pod coming up in a minute. Both Mega and Heavy coming up soon. Max is already in position for that Heavy.
I mean, Kelts does get taken down by Rafa and Maxter, but this is the kind of game they want to play. Kelts get up close, cause some chaos, and Sirius firing those rails in from a distance. That's how we saw them get so much success playing against Maestro. Is that the formation that they want now in this next part of Blood Covenant so that they can make this 7 frag comeback? There's going to be a final rotation of major items in a few moments, and then it's going to be all eyes on the quad damage.
Certainly will. These items are important because you need the biggest stack as possible in order to have an increased probability of being able to get that power up and then make your move. Now down by 7.
So we've got the Mega Health was taken by Cheetahs, we've got Heavy Armor has just been taken by Chicago Dogos. Who can get that poke damage before the power-up spawns by the teleporter. Rapper under a lot of pressure. Where's Kelts to help out? He's up on the side. Kelts gets another kill. 2 HP for Sirius, but Kelts has got what he needed. There's no big items, but that light armor is an absolute savior. It gives him a bit of wind in his sails to push forward and try to extract a couple more frags from this situation. Oh, down beautiful. Goes Maxter. Heavy armor up next. And Kelts is going to leave that one for Sirius. No, he's not. He just wants to get stuck in the fight. Needs to provide some support. And now ensuring that the spawn of Rapper doesn't sit back over at the heavy armor, retaining that control. Didn't get copious amounts of frag just then, but has got excessive control.
Yeah, that's the most important thing. And Kelts is actually taking quite a lot of damage as they're trying to progress. Great kill onto Rafa. And they're trying to stop him from going for the heavy. And it looks like Sirius manages to take down Maxter. Heavy's up in 10. Mega's now up.
They haven't pushed that, though, have they? They lost quite a bit of stack. They needed to get some 25s. They will get the heavy armor. Rafa and Maxter could be thinking about the rail at this point. Rafa, oh my god, comes in with the LG, but the close range rail shot. These are the clutch shots that they need to be landing. These are tilting shots for Rafa to receive. He knows he's close to getting those kills. Oh my god, Sirius, he keeps on landing.
And look, and now they've taken a lead, 37 to 35, and there's so much of a scuffle and chaos around that power room. You'd assume that one of the potential quads coming up next is being back ready. And they're trying to go for the heavy, do not manage to. Rafa does take down Kelts, but Sirius still going absolutely mad with that rail, and he's available himself.
I think Kelts lost a little bit of focus on the heavy for a moment, so there's a sort of minor mistake there, but not anything unrecoverable. However, Rafa with position up on the Mega Health. It's a 1-for-1 that happened down at the lower pillars. But we are in a sort of turbulent moment at the moment. Rafa with the Mega Health, best stack he's had for quite a while. And now we have got the all-important protection. It's taken by Rafa. He's on 100 HP. He is under a bit of pressure. And I think, can Kelts survive? No, he absolutely can't. And Sirius, oh my god, the pressure they put on him, he is landing some damage. But that is going to be a tied game now. This is to see who has the map advantage in this series. Can Kels and Sirius bring themselves a map closer to a reset, or can we get a map closer to Chicago Dogos taking the title?
You can see they're trying to keep the distance away from Rafa, but Rafa just making the correct read every time with the position which they could be at, even though they're trying to keep their distance. Good rail coming up from Maxet, and now it's their turn to potentially swing that momentum. Now up by two, as Mega is going to be up quite soon, as they're trying to at least make preparations for it, but it's going to be a big kill if he manages to stop, but Maxet takes both Celts and Sirius down, along with picking up the Mega. No light available around the pillars, but that's fine, he'll take that.
I think we just got the rail over there for Celts, it looks like. They're under a lot of pressure. There are weapon issues on the side of Cheetahs. Sirius without the rail, he's done a ridiculous... Oh no, maybe he does have a rail. We've got the LG, he gets taken down from the top. 45 to 41. We are most likely going to get to this quad, but I don't think we're going to get a whole lot further, especially if the control's retained by the Dogos.
Yeah, this quad needs to be taken by Cheetahs, and I'm not too sure how, considering the stacks at the moment.
Sirius and Celts have to challenge for the quad.
Yeah.
But damn if you do, damn if you don't, honestly.
Oh, good battle coming out. It's a huge play from Sirius. But the problem is that they've still got time to come up on the respawn and go for that quad. But Sirius is going to flank around as Celts actually committed suicide to restack, which is fair enough. This is going to be a good play from them. But they realize there's someone still at the rocket. They're trying to dive on in as Rafa does take down Celts. Sirius is on his own, and that could be the play they needed in order to get that quad.
Oh, he gets onto the quad, manages to get the kill. Max only needs one more, and Rafa's going to lock it down. That is Chicago Dogos putting themselves on tournament point here.
Unbelievable work, but fair play to the lads. But being 3-1, but yeah, there's still a little bit there. We can agree that it could take it to that map 5. Let's see if likes of Chicago Dogos do take this grand final 3-1, or if Cheetahs can take us to a final map here as we go straight into deep embrace. He's already taken quite a lot of damage, but it's actually distributed quite a lot of his own. Sirius come out with the LG, he's going to try and get enough if he can, doesn't manage to as Maxter does clean him up.
We've got, again, fast champions to work with. It looks like Sirius wants to play on the Ranger. He's the only medium champion over here. I think Sirius should be applying a bit more pressure to Rafa. Does get the kill with the shotgun. Relatively even start. Sirius, you can see he's limping around with barely any health. I think he's just, decides I just essentially want to throw away my life, get a better starting stack. And again, back and forth, 4-4, 45 seconds in.
All tied up here during this first minute. It's been very back and forth. These close range rails coming up from Sirius has been unreal. Rafa finally takes him down. Mega's up in 7. And Celts now just trying to stand his ground, but good rails coming out again. Sirius finishing up with the rocks. And great position from Celts now just to wait for a little bit, pick up that heavy as Sirius has managed to bag that. And now Celts is just in a great position, top middle, just to try and suffocate him if they can. But Sirius is also there with the rail in case they do push. Good rockets, good orb as well from Sirius. It looked pretty bleak, but now managed to chain things up a little bit. And Celts has also taken down Maxter with the power-ups now coming up in the next 5 seconds.
I mean, are they trying to double up onto the protection as well? No, I think we've got Celts coming back. He's going to take the quad. There is a mega health. Get a little bit of a safety net on your stack. And Celts is going to know roughly what side of the map they're on. Is he going to try and push into it? Because they do have the protection. The Athena is wielding the protection.
After tanking that last round, this will be huge. And they managed to take him down. Is he going to pick up as well? He actually tried to bait it, which is, do you know what? Even though he got taken down, I do respect that decision.
Yeah. We're trying to get some of the P5 rockets onto it, but wasn't quite able to land the damage. Either way, Cheetahs are holding a small advantage, but this early on in the game, it really doesn't mean too much. Celts. Just pushing through, giving no damns whatsoever. Sirius with the orb kill. I think we've had a couple of those just on this map alone.
Unreal. Look at the scoreline here. So 15-8.
I don't want to say anything at this point. I want a fifth map. in this series.
I do as well. I'm not superstitious, which is why I'm so happy about it.
But there's so much to be done. This is really good what we're seeing in terms of the efficacy of their aim. They're fighting brilliantly. They're supporting each other well. But we need to see some more good power-up runs. And ideally have them on the quad. Cats missing an opening rail shot. That's a lot of wasted value with the stack that he had.
Really was indeed. Both items coming up shortly. I think it's a very important defensive rail. Tickles him a bit with the LG. Actually managed to clean that up, but Kelsey straight in with the trade. And Maxter was top mid, dropping down to see if it can rotate back around. But that's the last of the items. The Palps will be coming up next. And Maxter trying to hold his ground and hold that high advantage here. A few rockets coming out from Sirius, but managed to get Rafa in the meantime. It's only Maxter left.
Where's
Where
Kels?
Is Kels? He came off the spawn, but still the direct comes out. They're trying to push him forward. Maxter coming out with both those rockets, and they're going to be gunning for that protection. And will they get away with it? Don't think as yet. Finally gets it. Looking to try and get on up. But he has got the weaponry in the arsenal, and that is going to be Rafa with both power-ups to try and tie things up and maybe even take the lead. What a stack he's got now.
Yeah, I think there's 5 seconds difference between the two power-ups, which will be useful for later on. But Rafa finding Kels, helplessly running around just there. Rocket, there we go, two side. Kels on for the double here during this run.
We'll get a bit from it though. Finally take the lead. As you remember, it was like literally 15, was it to 9 or to 6? Something silly like that. Now it's 4 minutes in, and now Rafa having to try and back away. A lot of damage coming out here from Cheaters. And Rafa just trying to back away, trying to rotate back around. Still a good amount of damage though, considering he's backing away, but will get finally cleaned up by Kelts. And Maxter tickling him just a tad. That tri-bolt, waiting for him to go for that TP. Nice attempt.
Yeah. Awkward angle, the tri-bolt in particular, actually. Oh, Sirius does manage to get the shot right at the end. I'm gonna watch him for just a moment. We have got major items spawning. Beautiful rail shot. Getting potentially hit from both sides. Rafa takes the damage. But that is going to be Maxter who will pick up the heavy armor in the end.
Still all tied up here. There's actually barely any segregation with the items at all, apart from the two power-ups. And this is where the quads will be so, so important. Now, if you get that quad first, whoever gets it will have time, maybe not to get the protection, but at least contest it and be a bit of a nuisance. And that was well played there from Maxter. And now to push it on forward, trying to collect everything he can from the murder hole to keep his stack as healthy as he can. Grabs the Mega, backs away. Now he's looking to double back and add some more influence in terms of damage, but it's actually had to take a lot of damage there with the LG. Good shoddy damage, but Sirius managed to clean up Maxter as well. Quad's up in two. Will he be able to get it? Rafa's trying to make a go of it. Gets a trade, but the quad has been picked up by Kels. And looking at it, he's trying to get involved and trying to get there before the protection actually does spawn, but they've already been there already. Kels only on 70 HP. This is crucial here and need to be very careful about his positioning.
The major items are spawning, so the heavy is up, so is the mega health. Trying to push him off. He's in a lot of trouble over there. Just the wrong position to be in. He could have backed off and had the heavy armor instead. Maxter is going to have a lot to work with at the end. Still just a small lead for Cheaters, but it is fragile. So fragile right now.
It really is. All tied up again as Rafa just taken down Sirius. Mega will be up next, by the heavy shortly afterwards. Maxter now just trying to get away with that light. Rafa finishing it off Kelts after the damage displayed from Maxter there. Good rail coming out from Maxter again. Looking for the second. Great stuff there. As he now managed to extend their lead by two. And again, just continuing with his back-to-back rails. Barely missing a beat. Good rocket as well with Rafa finish things up on Sirius.
Rafa stopping him from having to fall out of the map. Very generous. Rafa is a generous god.
He's quite generous when he wants to be.
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh my god, that direct.
And the Rafa there, is he going to be able, sorry, am I actually able to clean it up? Not quite.
Stay alive again.
They are pushing him on the heavy. Did the damage, but the hook is what's going to keep him going.
I'm worried about the stack here. The sides of Cheaters, it's not looking too great, and Rafa's had quite a similar stack for quite a while now.
Yeah, it's good, really good control that we're getting from Chicago Dogos for what you can have on Deep Embrace. Maxter pushing Kelts off the map. Sirius, maybe in a small amount of trouble. Rafa's stack not looking too shiny. Mega health is taken, we've got 5 seconds until the quad, and actually, could this be working out for Cheaters? quad is going to get taken. Kels does get the kill. He is so low. He wants to go for the double. Both power-ups. Now can he push forward? He needs some health and armor desperately. There's no major items up for a while.
And he's on the chase. He's trying to go around to the shot. He cleans up Rafa now, trying to find Maxter on the respawn. Will he find him? He's actually hiding around top mid. He's just gone past him. He's going back around. He's still got one top mid, one shoddy. Will he even go back? He won't go back to check shoddy because he's just come from that angle. But wow, what I can say is great plays coming out from both Maxter and Rafa, keeping their distance away from the protection and what a follow. Kels are still pushing in. Good LG coming out here. Cleans him up. Maxter gets the trade onto Kels.
I can't believe he's going for those close range rails. You've got to hit something serious. You've got to hit it. Oh, God.
But Cheaters must get the trade.
Barely with a lead at the moment. I think we're 40 to 40. We are going to get to the 50 frag mark well before the time limit. This mark, it's just which team is going to get there first.
Oh,
remember,
God.
Chicago Dogos, they are on tournament point. If they win this, they win the title. 41-41.
Maxter did so much damage to get themselves in this matchup and stopping from Cheetahs to even get the lead. But speaking of the lead, it has changed hands now. Maxter must get one. Rafa gets another. Two down now. We could potentially be seeing the last power-ups of the game. Depending on how this goes, Rafa's attack is so much damage and they're well aware of that, looking for him here, but instead gets taken down around the corner. And Rafa finish up serious, and Maxter also takes down Kels. These power-ups are crucial now for Cheetahs.
Maxter just stole the mega health as well. Rafa's going to come back into the fight with some stack to work with. Everything's spawning at the same time in 20 seconds as well. It's going to be absolute carnage in a moment. We've got rails for rails. Cheetahs cannot make mistakes anymore. There's four more kills. There we go. Two kills quickly for the Cheetahs. Can they break back into this? This is a good time to get Chicago Dogos weaponless. But these rockets are doing a lot of damage. Huge rail shots. Oh, the clutch rail! Kels, bring it back in. He's got a mega health that he can get. He has to settle down. They still have a disadvantage. There's still protection on the side of Chicago Dogos. How do they break this stalemate and get to the 50 mark first?
They need to be cautious, though. With the slash, it does have protection and the full stack. So this is going to be brutal here. Even though they're one up, this is being mindful of that. And what a railway. This could be an opening there, a window of opportunity as they're trying to
Sirius?
Break back around. But Sirius is looking to try and get more done. He's actually gone behind. Max has taken out Sirius. Will take the protection guy. Will be able to get it. Doesn't get it in the end, but manages to play.
Oh!
Rafa stops him, picks up the protection. And now Chicago Dogos are just one frag away.
One
winning
more.
KeenCon 2024 as having to back away. Finally manages to get it. And Rafa and Maxter take the grand finals and win KeenCon 2024 in style. What a way to finish up that series.
Unbelievable.
And commiserations to Kels and Sirius. That was really, really well played.
Amazing performance that they managed to put on just then. I mean, they really kept it as close as they possibly could and certainly challenging Chicago Dogos more than the other teams.